This is a great moment right here.
Hey, welcome everybody. Good morning. This is Brian with Team Aquascape. It is day 6 out here.
Brian, why don't you let the folks out there know kind of where we're at on the project here and why you are unrolling this roll liner.
So this is a 20 by 50. We sized this not only to be big enough for our wetland filter over here, okay. So we want to use 20 by 30 of it for that section. We're going to use the other 20 by 20 over here. Now 20 feet seems really wide for a stream and waterfall, but if you come over here, I'll show you why we're using such a big liner. Really, if you look at the width of the rocks, so you see the rock with the water bottle, yep, on it over there? We need to get liner all the way from there all the way over to that other area there. One of my biggest pet peeves on a job is being handcuffed to creativity because the liner says we don't have the room to go further. So an extra 5 feet, 10 feet with your streamliner really allows you a whole lot more possibilities and keeps it from leaking.
Guys out there watching the video probably wondering what the heck's going on. So the way the waterfalls was built, all these rocks are actually sitting on a big bed of gravel to help raise this rock up because it was a little too short. So what I'm doing, foaming over the top of it and putting what we call a bib liner in. Even though we're not using liner on this, we're using fabric. So what I'm going to do is cover this entire bed of gravel in here with foam and then stick this geotextile underlayment down on top. The nice thing about this stuff is over time it gets clogged with all that sediment and it turns into basically like a big layer of concrete over the top of it for that water to travel over and not actually go down and infiltrate in through the gravel, so we won't be losing it back behind the rocks. We're getting the water to travel over the top of the rocks the way we want it to. All I'm doing is just sealing up basically this false bottom. We're almost there.
You know what time it is?
What time is it?
It's almost lunchtime, which also means we're digging the bog filter. First time we've kept to our schedule. So everything's done over here. You can even see Juan and Micho putting in some plants and stuff, trying to get creative on the edges. But we're done with big boulders over there. So Jack is prepping this site over here so we can start digging the bog filter next. We've got a 15 block wetland filter going in. It'll go down about 3 feet deep, come up through that series of aqua blocks, another layer of small cobbles, and then smaller and smaller aggregate as we get to the top. We're on schedule. Depth of our bog filter. That is solid, solid rock. So I like the trick that you were using, just put the garden hose up here. You put the garden hose up, and even though it's not the pressure of our waterfall, not even close, you get to see where water's escaping. And so sometimes what happens, it looks like you've got an area here, yep, where water was escaping back behind maybe where a light was or something.
It was, like I forgot yesterday that I ended up pulling this rock up to raise it, and I never got a chance to get back behind there and foam it. And then these rocks look like incredible together, but there's a really tiny vein down in here, and I'll end up pushing that foam back down, but it was losing water there too, so yeah.
Awesome.
So we're at the very last part of this pond construction. So we've got water that's gonna be coming into this entire area. This is called an intake skimmer or intake bay. We've got two pump vaults here that are gonna house four pumps. Each of those pumps is gonna be feeding different parts of the pond. We've got an urn, a wetland filter, big waterfall on the other side, and we also have some jets that are gonna be circulating the bottom of the pond. So all that is coming to the heart of the system here. This is where all the debris will be sucked in and then it can be manually removed later on. It's just a simple skimmer net.
How do you feel about our progress? progress today on day 7.
Dude, we kicked some major butt today. I can't believe we stayed on track with the challenges that we've had with the access and the rock in the ground and all that kind of stuff. So I'm really happy. I think tomorrow's going to be, I don't want to jinx it, but tomorrow's
going to be an easy day. It's so awesome. Got everything buttoned up here over in our bog filter. You can see this. We just have to trim up some liner back behind me, but this is looking fantastic. Got kind of a multi-leveled thing going on. Water's going to come up out of here. We've also got the upflow from the bog filter all coming down through this big waterfall. Started kind of planning out where this bridge will come in the future. And then, like Jack said, the intake bay's getting all set up. So tomorrow we should be able to wrap this up really fast, start adding water.
I can only assume with you rinsing on the pond means we're pretty stinking close to filling it.
Pond is done. We have to fix up our fish cave that somebody broke yesterday. Fix this up. We got Micho and Juan over there setting the footings for the bridge to go across. Once those two are done, we can start filling this thing. While this is filling, we'll bang out the intake bay and then just start doing our touch-up stuff all the way around. We have an enormous amount of garbage, dirt, grading, and plumbing that has to get done today. And so there's a super good chance we get done today, but let's keep our fingers crossed.
Jack, we're almost done with the intake bay,
which is the last big piece of this pond,
right? Which feels incredible. it's day eight, right? Help me understand what this is. Like, it's a skimmer on steroids, essentially, right?
Yeah, so most of the ponds that you guys build have skimmer boxes on it. That's what Aquascape manufactures, like the Signature 1000. And that would work on a pond that was smaller than this without all this other stuff going on, because we have an urn, we've got a wetland filter, we've got a big waterfall and jets, as well as the feature behind you. So we're not just running one pump, we're running four pumps in this whole system. So it wouldn't make a lot of sense to put a small skimmer box here, let alone put two skimmer boxes, because it would look kind of funny with two fake lids there. So this is a great alternative if you're moving a lot of water and you're moving a lot of pumps and stuff like that. So giving more space, surface area, and it's a great collection area for people to come in when it's all finished. You're gonna have about like 6 inches of water in here, which is gonna make it easy for a homeowner to come out with just a simple skimmer net, scoop that stuff out of there.
Sure.
And it's gonna be a 5 second maintenance thing. Not that emptying a skimmer is hard, it's just this is gonna be simple. Two things that I really love about intake bays. Number one, it's an extension to the pond. It looks so natural. Yeah. You see water coming in, but you don't see any pumps, you don't see any plumbing. You just think to yourself, well, I guess it's just part of the pond. The other thing is the fish can swim all the way in here and back out. And it's just a cool effect because there's gonna be a bridge right behind me here.
Yep.
You've just got a huge like 10-foot extension to the pond that's totally accessible to the fish.
That's gonna be awesome. Why would somebody not need an intake bay or choose to go the skimmer route?
So if you don't need to have a whole bunch of pumps on the pond and you're running one, maybe two pumps, it's gonna be a lot less money to put a skimmer in because you're just dealing with putting a unit in instead of constructing from scratch a skimming system. So it's definitely gonna be a cost benefit to use a skimmer as opposed to building an intake. But when you get into multiple pumps and all that kind of stuff and you need to have more space and you can afford the aesthetic, then I think this is a great option.
All right, guys, welcome back. It is day 9. We were talking last night as we were finishing up all the lights and everything else, and it was amazing to see the reaction on the customer's face when those lights went on, and it was as genuine as our own. I remember sitting out here and the lights came on, we were like, it was so awesome. But the other thing we were reminiscing about was what has actually happened in 8, and then today being the 9th day. 60 tons of boulders, over 15 tons of gravel, 120 feet of face feet wall that went in. Urns, wetland filters, intake bays, 4 semi-loads of dirt have been removed out of here. I mean, it's just been an epic process, and this is what we got to create.
So usually when we do stuff like this, it's like down to the wire. We've got zero time even for finish shots when we're done. Today, we actually have a day to go around and tweak everything, because inevitably, like, you get it fired up and there's things you want to change. There's things that might have been an edge too low or something. And that's what I think today is for, is just clean up and make sure that this thing is 1,000%
bumped. Yeah, we want to pull out some dirt here, clean up this. We're tweaking lights. You know, after we turned down all those lights, we said, where do we need a couple more? We've got a couple more, so we're going to add those. We still have to put in our ion gen and our dosing system, get some of those water treatment things set up. We want to just kind of leave this yard no different than any yard we've ever worked at back home. So kind of clean up, get our way out of here, get all of our tools, get our edges buttoned up, get the front yard all straightened up. We've got some pile of rocks that we have to deal with out there. But get this ready so the landscapers can come in here and do their magic. There's going to be an unbelievable patio that comes in, hangs out right over the top of this. So this liner will go from that, and then that patio stone will sit kind of cantilevered out over the edge of this pond all the way around this area. We've got a deck that's coming in over in here. That deck with the tea house, if they open up that tea house, it'll look awesome. But a deck's gonna sit up here where you see all of that gravel. We've gotta add a couple boulders up on top just for erosion control, kind of rake up some stuff up there, and then plants can come in. And I know Andrew and his wife are gonna make sure this backyard looks like a paradise that nobody's ever seen before.
You're gonna jump in?
Yeah.
Oh my Hey guys, if you enjoy seeing this kind of stuff, make sure you hit the like button, subscribe, tell us your favorite part, whatever it may be, and we'll keep doing this for you. Till next time.